guys, it's Mike from Craft Beer Storm, also founder, owner of Bear Brewing Company. We're back in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. I was at the Craft Brewers Convention in Denver. I took the red eye back last night. I'm sorry I didn't get this out earlier, but things are happening, but I'm getting it out. So, like I said, I'm doing it three times a week. You're going to get your podcasts, and here we go. But I want to give you a sample of what I record a lot of stuff. Like, I think over 40 different, sound bites and people and interviews. But what I did is I put together for Country Malt Group, also Canada Malting Limited, and the man, the myth, the legend, James Lagren of Lagren Malt. They're all sold under Country Malt Group, which is providing great malts. And, they supply me with great hops as well. So let's get to it. Just enjoy it, And then next week I'm going to be mixing up more of these snippets and sound bites and get them out there, consolidate them, and just a lot of knowledge. 360, everything from grains to hops to filtration to cans to labels to bottles, everything. So get ready. But now this one's for Country Malt Group. Okay, take a listen. Hey, we're here. We're in the hall. And we just heard Bruce Dickinson, he was awesome, but now I'm wandering around the main hall here, and I bumped into Kyron Flett, Canada Malty Company. How you doing, Kyron?
Great, yeah.
So what are you guys doing? I think I bought some stuff from you in the past. You're associated with Country Malting.
Yeah, so we're the largest malting company in Canada, and we do all base malt, specialty malt, and we're distributed through Country Malt Group.
Awesome, yeah. No, so I'm looking for James Lagren. I'll find him. But so how do you like the conference so far, I guess?
Conference is great. We kind of feel that we're the conduits between the farmer and the end user, the brewers. And so anytime we get to sponsor an event on either end and be part of it, interact with our end users, it's a fantastic time.
So you actually malt the grain that comes from farmers.
Yeah.
Go into the malting process.
Yeah, so we buy anywhere from 1,500 to 2,000 farmers in a year. We buy barley, wheat, rye, oats. We take that grain, convert it through a 6 to 8 day process, and convert it to the malt that brewers love to eat and brew with.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's great. And you have all different types of you malt things differently in order to produce a different type of malt. Like there's chocolate malt, and is there anything specialized that you do, or a lot of them?
Yeah, so a lot of times specialty, it depends on the length that you're kilning it or whether you're removing it from the germination and throwing it into a roaster. So our sister company, Great Western, they do a lot of roasting. We stick to the base malts and do some specialty kilning. But our focus is, the Munichs, the Pales, the Pilsens, and the Turos.
Yeah, it's just a lot to the malting process and to making beer. That's what I keep telling people. It's not like you put water in. You put powder into water and then make beer. It's just a huge process that's gone through. And it's
yeah.
Just
well, I mean, it takes half a year for the grain to even get out of the field before we put our hands on it. So, it's a longer process than a lot of us realize. And I think the more people get connected from our food to, farm to field, farm to plate, same thing, farm to glass. Everyone's getting interested in where the grain's coming from and how the whole process relates to brewing and end users and the consumers. So.
Awesome. All right. Well, thanks for all you do. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
Karen. All right.
Thank you for stopping by.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
And we're back at the Craft Brewers Conference last day. And I came by Country Malt Group and I saw Adam Reed. He's a New England territory manager. How you doing, Adam?
I'm doing well, Michael. How are you?
I'm okay. It's freaking snowed yesterday. It was 80 the day before. And it snowed, and now it's white. Denver's white, so.
Yeah, I thought we left New England to escape that, but it seems to have followed us here. So.
It's unbelievable. It was 80 degrees. That was awesome. I'm not prepared for this snow. Anyway, Country Malt Group. I buy my grains from Country Malt Group, and specifically Lagren, the family malt. That's from Ireland, which is delicious malt, and I appreciate you guys supplying it. Tell me about Country Malt in general.
Sure. Well, we're... A guy named Brian Bayshard up in Champlain, New York, founded it you know, about 25 years ago. That'll be 25 years next year. You know, it's amazing. He was out of a shed in his backyard back then, and it's blossomed into a literally a global company at this point, which is just kind of stupefying for all of us that are involved. I mean, I was ordering from North Country Malt Supply, which is what it was called originally, you know, many years ago when I was starting as a brewer, and now we're, you know, part of the Great Western Canada Malting, Baird's Malting family. So they're actually all under the same corporate umbrella as us now. And, you know, but we obviously work with a lot of other suppliers like James Loughran and you know, Thomas Fawcett Malting, you know, Best Malls out of Germany. So we work with a lot of people, and they're all wonderful to work with. And, but it's amazing. It feels like every 2 or 3 years, just like the industry, we also undergo, like, sort of, you know, radical developments that were kind of hard to predict, you know?
It's just hard to do it, yeah. I interviewed Bart Watson, the BA economist, chief economist, and just stuff changes like every, like 6 months, right?
It's incredible. It's incredible. It's a lot of fun to be a part of.
Yeah.
You know, obviously it's tricky from a business perspective because we're trying to base our decision-making off what we think industry trends are going to be, and it just, it's so hard because things change so fast that, you know, it's a lot of fun, but it's... yeah, there are challenges involved with it too for everybody, I think. And, but it's a great industry to be a part of. I mean, the people involved, you can't get better people than the brewing industry. So.
Everybody's awesome, especially at this conference. And I met like heavy duty people here, like, you know. And they're like owners and like original, like, you know, founders of things. And I'm like, my God, you're standing here. That's cool. Hey, let me get a podcast from you.
Yeah, it's...
Let me get some sound bites.
The best of the best are here. CBC is always my favorite week of the year. It's like Christmas for the craft beer industry. And, you can turn around. Ken Grossman's standing right next to you.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
It's crazy. But, all right, I appreciate your time, Adam. I'll let you get back to it.
Oh, well, thank you, Michael. I appreciate it. And thank you very much for doing business with us. We appreciate it. And you know, it's a pleasure to be on.
That's great stuff. Thank you. All right, so I finally found James Loughran. He's the they supply the base for all our beer and Loughran malt. How you doing, James?
Great, Michael. How are you?
Oh, I'm glad I bumped into you. I never met you before. I talked to you on the phone. We did the podcast, but you're making awesome barley out there. And how are you finding the conference?
Yeah, it's a busy show. This is my fifth CBC, and every year it just keeps getting busier and bigger and more interesting. And it's always a great event.
Did you see the keynote speaker before?
I didn't, no. It was Bruce, wasn't it?
It was Bruce Dickinson. Yeah, Iron Maiden. I saw like five shows already.
Yeah.
I wanted to take a picture of him, but I couldn't. So, you know, what are you going to do?
Yeah, I was sorry I just didn't get a chance to see it. But unfortunately, I had to spend some time with some...
That's great. Else. You talk to a lot of people. You're getting them, you know, making them aware that you have this Irish barley. That's really awesome.
Yeah, that's right. We've been... Country Malt distribute barley, our malt for us here in the US and Canada, and it's barley that we grow on our own farm in Ireland. Excuse me. And we just find that the climate under which we operate, under which we farm, just allows us to grow barley that is low in protein, big fat kernels, and really rich in flavour. And we kind of put those things together and we're able to help brewers brew beer which is more flavoursome and kind of balances a lot of the hops that's out there in the market.
Yeah, we use it all the time. We use it for all our beer, you know, as the base. I think that was the idea. We wanted to use Irish barley as the base for all our beer, and the beers have been coming out great. People just come in and they try a flight of beer, and they're like, I don't see one beer that I don't like. I mean, they're all really good. So.
Oh, it's great to see it. And like, I know you've been using it for a couple of years now as well, I think, and it's been, you know, we get a sales report from CMG, and Every month, I'm always checking to see if your name's on it.
Country Malt Group. Yeah. We gotta keep. Yeah, but it's really awesome. It's good to meet you, man.
Yeah, and you are you hanging around for?
Yeah. I'll be here until Thursday, so I'll bump into you.
No, that'll be great. That'll be really, really good. Good to see you.
Yeah, that was Adam Reed, the territory sales manager, and Kyron Flett, who was with Canada Malting. And also the man, the myth, the legend, James Loughran from Loughran Malt. He's in Ireland. He owns the farm there, and they're producing really good stuff. So that's my podcast for today. I told you I was going to get it out there, and I did. If you like what we're doing, you like our podcasts, please, please, please go onto iTunes. Give us a rating. Give us a review. Contact me, Michael, at crapbeerstorm.com. Tell me what I'm doing. Am I doing things right? Do you want to see something else? If you have any brewers or anybody suggestions, you know, send them my way. Connect us. We'll get them on. But I had an excellent couple of days out at the craft brewers convention out in Denver. Really great, tremendous people. You know, community, awesome. Where can you go? There's like 14,000 people that are happy. I don't know, but I did. I went to Denver, and everybody was great. And I'm just going to go every year. I think it was fantastic. Thank you, Brewers Association. You gave me a media pass. You guys rock. We also interviewed a couple of individuals from the Brewers Association. Really great people as well. We'll get those out to you next week. But for now, that's all I have for today. Have a great weekend. We'll see you on Monday. Take care.